Hi, I'm John Cash. Welcome to John Cash Ministries and Revelations Church's Daily Devotion. Today, I want to talk to parents out there. You can be parents of small kids, teenagers, or even grandparents, even great-grandparents. This is God's warning to parents. We have three verses. We're going to start in Ephesians 6:4. Now listen closely. The Bible says this, "Fathers, do not exasperate your children. Instead, bring them up in the training and the instruction of the Lord." The Bible specifically warns, not just fathers, but mothers as well, any parents, to not exasperate your kids. What does it mean to exasperate? Let me give you some definitions from dictionary.com. To irritate. No, wait a second. You're a parent. You're like, no, my kid's supposed to irritate me. Well, guess what? You can irritate your kid as well. It's not hard to do. I'm learning that. I have a 12-year-old boy. So the definition, to irritate or to provoke to a high degree, to annoy extremely. Okay? Listen to a few other definitions. Okay? To increase the intensity or violence of disease, pain, or feelings. In other words, the picture of exasperating is to do something that just gets the blood boiling. One more, and that is this. In the botany, which is a science, this word is used for the terms rough or projecting points. Okay? In other words, the picture here of exasperating your kids is you kind of taking something and poking at them. And then they get really annoyed. Now, what's a great way to describe this so that every parent can understand when they are exasperating their kid? Well, I think James 2:13 gives us a great spiritual principle. Listen closely. Because judgment without mercy will be shown to anyone who has not been merciful. Watch this. Mercy triumphs over judgment. Did you know that God's mercy triumphs over his judgment? Does. Jesus did not come to the earth the first time to judge. He came to save. He came to have mercy. If God is trying to decide, do I show mercy now or do I show judgment? Because he does show both. And he can't make a decision. Not like God can't make a decision, but he's like, even, what's he going to do? He's going to show mercy. The problem with parents, especially parents in churches and parents who are very religious and understand the standards of God, is that they know the standards, and if the standards aren't met, they become angry and ugly. When you become angry and ugly with your kids, especially if your anger is not righteous anger, well, your kids will become embittered. So understand, folks, what we need to be doing here is showing mercy and love. Now, that doesn't mean that the kids don't get in trouble. That doesn't mean that there won't be times for discipline and judgment. But I think sometimes parents go overboard and we push them too far. And when we do, it embitters them. All right? So remember, if you can't decide, show mercy. Show love. Colossians 3:21 says this, "Fathers, do not," and this can be mothers too, "do not embitter your children or they will become discouraged." Folks, I can tell you, I've met a lot of kids who are now adults and they left church. They left God. Why? Well, the main reason is because of the judgmental, mean people inside the church. They did not feel God's love from the people in the church. They did not feel God's love from their parents. They felt this very narrow-minded judgmentalism always shooting their way, poking them, exasperating them, embittering them. What's the word embitter mean? It means to make bitter, to cause, to feel bitterness. Another word, to sour, to rankle, to envenom. Which means literally they're injecting spiritual venom in our kids when we are embittering them or exasperating them. Take it easy on the kids, folks. Yes, discipline and love. Yes, punish when you need to. But I think if they saw more of God's love and less of his judgment, you might find you're not going to be exasperating them. You're not going to be embittering them. And they're going to grow up falling in love with God. And that's what we all want as parents. God bless you. Thank you for your support of John Cash Ministries and Revelations Church.